Hey, Casey Stubbs here. Today I'm going to teach you two things. Okay, this is a two for one. Number one, you're going to get my back testing techniques, how to back test. Really important to back test. And then number two is I'm going to give you access to one of my best strategies. So this is a great video. Make sure you watch it, learn from it, use it to make money. I teach you things here so that you can make money. So make it happen. All right, now. Back testing. Why is back testing important? It's important because we don't want to jump in willy-nilly, jump in without doing our homework. You got to do the work, people. If you're going to be successful, you got to do the work. You can't just expect to jump in without any plan. It's like jumping out of an airplane without a parachute. It's not going to end well, right? I deal with traders all the time. You don't want to do the work on the front end. You're like, I'll just start trading and see what happens. That's not going to work, okay? So it's important to know if a strategy is going to work before you put real money in. And here's what I recommend. I recommend that you back test a strategy and then you forward test it on demo before you go live. And then once you do that, you can get a prop firm and scale quickly. Go to globalproptrader.com, my prop firm. We have the best prop firm. There's a shameless plug in the middle of the education. But do that, but don't do it until you know you're going to be good. I see people, again, they do it without being ready. Don't do it without ready. Like, I get it. You get your training wheels on. Do this. Okay, so that's the benefit. You know if it's going to work ahead of time. So let's go ahead and get started. Step one is you use this tool in MetaTrader called the Strategy Tester. Okay, and it's right here. See that? Right here, Strategy Tester. You click that. Okay, now you look at the Strategy Tester, and then there's a special tool here from FX Blue called Trading Simulator. Now, there are ways to automate our strategies, which I'm going to be doing a training on that very soon if I get interest. AI is the future. AI is amazing right now. The stocks on AI are exploding. But let me just tell you, as a trader, you need to learn how to get into AI. And I'm doing an AI training very soon. If you want me to do it, let me know in the comments so that I know that there's interest, so that I know that people are going to learn how to implement their own AI. But anyways, enough of that. So you use this trading simulator called from FX Blue. So you go to FX Blue website and get the trading simulator. I'm not going to show you how to do that. I figure that you guys are smart enough to figure that out on your own. I'm not going to baby you. I know that you're great traders, you're intellectual people. I don't need to show you everything. Okay, so for this strategy, then I'm going to be testing the pound dollar, and I'm going to be testing it over here on the daily time frame. And I'm going to test for about 3 years, okay, 2.5 years. That's the testing period that I'm going to do. Now we have to come up with a strategy, okay? We're going to come up with a strategy. And you have to, this is important, and I would put it on text in the screen, but I just don't have time to edit the videos. I'm not a cool Mr. Beast type where I'll put cool text on the screen or some of those other great YouTubers. I'm here to teach you. I want you to do smart things. I want you to make money, but I'm not gonna put the text on the screen. You can write it out. Step number one is you gotta have your strategy in play. And by the way, I probably had 5 step number ones. So you can add the steps. You gotta have the strategy. Okay, so for this strategy, what I'm going to do is I'm going to get a MACD crossover entry. Okay, I'm going to get a MACD crossover entry. That simple. And I'm going to do a simple 1-to-1 risk to reward ratio. Now, that's probably not the most profitable. Let me go off of a little side note here and just explain something. There's many money management strategies. There's a 1-to-1. There's a 0.5-to-1. And so when I say 1-to-1, I mean you're risking $10. You're risking $10 to make 10. A 0.5-to-1 means you're risking $10 to make 5. Then there's the 2-to-1 where you're risking $10 to make 2. And then there's trailing stop where you trail your stop as the trade goes in your direction. Like right here, you get in short and you trail your stop. So I'm not going to test those today, but here's a little bonus note. Write it in the comments so you don't forget. Write it on your notepad. Go into your email and write it. Test each money management strategy. And I hate to be giving you so much things to do, but if you want me to go over all of the different money management strategies in a training, let me know, because I gotta know that you're actually gonna watch what I do so that I'm putting out the best content possible. But I have 7 different money management strategies that I have been testing, and that way we know which one works, because we could take this same strategy with one money management strategy and lose money, but then we run it with a different money management strategy and it actually makes money. So the money management strategy is just as important as the entry strategy. So for this video, we're gonna do a 1-to-1 risk to reward ratio with a MACD cross. And this is a special MACD called the Savvy MACD. And it's available again on my website, and it has a special dashboard that comes with it called the Savvy MACD dashboard, and it does signals and things like that. Very cool. You can grab it. I'll put the link for that in the description. But anyways, you can do this with a regular MACD too. This is just my little toy, because I like to make toys to make my life easier. Get in the habit of thinking about how to make your life easier. You won't regret it. Now that we got that, we're ready to go. We've got our strategy. We know it's a MACD cross with a 1-to-1 risk to reward ratio. Learn to talk, dude. Okay. So then we click start. Okay, we're going to click start. Now it's going to load up the template here. And let's see what we got. Okay, so it's got a couple extra indicators that I don't want, so I'm just gonna delete the indicator, the RSI, because it's not part of my strategy this time. And, you know, things like that. The ADX is not part of my strategy, so we're just gonna make that happen. Okay, let's see, can I delete this indicator window? All right, so now I've got my tool running. My strategy, I gotta delete this indicator window. If it doesn't delete, well then I'm just out of luck. Okay, so we're gonna drop our lot size down here. I got it at 50 lots, that's a little large. We're gonna go to 25 lots. Yeah, when you roll with me, you're rolling with the big boys. Okay, and so now I'm just waiting for this MACD to cross. So we're gonna now roll the timer, and so we're gonna watch it, okay? So what I'm gonna do now, and this is much slower than what I thought it was. See, it's because the daily chart is a little bit slower because it's a full day. So there we go, we got the day. Let's see how long this actually takes. I might have to fast forward this video. So actually, let me stop this and try something different. We're gonna do this, and we're gonna go, instead of doing on every tick, we're gonna do it on open prices. It makes it a little bit faster. So we're gonna restart this. So this is just a little note. This is every tick, it's the most accurate. If you're doing lower time frames, you can do this, but if you want it to be faster, just go with open prices, so it misses some of the fluctuations. But we're gonna just try that, okay? So actually, let me do something else here real quick. I'm gonna resave this template. Click save, this is a bonus. If you save your template as tester, it'll automatically load that. So now I won't have all those windows. Okay, so we're gonna close this, and we're gonna restart this. So we're gonna go, and we're gonna try that. All right. Okay, so now it's paused. We got it on 25. Let's go ahead. There we go, much better, right? Much better. And you can maybe speed it up a little bit, but I don't want it to go too fast because I missed the trade. Okay, so I'm gonna just take the buy here. And we're gonna speed this up. And then now I'm gonna pause it just to make sure that I have, and by the way though, I'm like way late. This would have been a huge winner. So we're gonna move this down, and we're gonna go for 83 pips, and we're gonna move this up to 83 because we're gonna do just a 1-to-1. Just a 1-to-1. Okay. Okay, there we go, it closed. So that was actually, okay. Let's see what happened. We're gonna go to our I'm going to slow this down and we're going to go to info. And this, you know, it takes a little bit of practice, but yeah, that first trade was a winner, $7,000. So now we're going to speed it up a little bit. Wait for it. Okay. It just crossed, but it crossed back over. So this would have actually probably been a loser, but I didn't get into the trade. So I'm just going to take the sell here anyways, just to try to keep it legit. So this is one of the problems with backtesting, is you got to be on the ball if you're using this method. If you do another, there's another manual type of backtest where you just go through and watch the charts manually. You don't need to use this tool. Okay, so right now we got a cross, so I'm going to sell it, and then I'm going to, okay, there we go. And what happened with that? That was a loser. And I'm going to change my stop loss here to 100 and my take profit to 100 because it's just triggering, the 30 pips is just too small for this. Okay, now you see that would have been a much bigger move had I had a better stop loss. Okay, we're going to watch it. Look at that move. Wow. I like it. That's when you can make the money in the market. You let that thing ride. That's a 2-month trade. Okay, we're getting ready to cross back over again. Okay, see, another, it went another leg down. So the one cross is gone for 3 months, 4 months. So these things can last a long time. But this is a daily chart. If you're going to do it on other time frames, obviously it's going to be a little different. Okay, we just got the cross. So now I'm going to do the buy. Okay, and I'm going to slow it way down, and I'm going to adjust my stop loss. So I'm going to unpause it. See, now I'm going to adjust my stop. So I have it at 100 and 100. Am I okay with that? Yeah, I think I'm okay with that. So now I'm going to speed it back up. Okay, there was a loser. Okay. So now we're going to do it again. Okay, it looks like it crossed down again. So now we're going to do a sell. Okay. And so you guys get the idea. I'm going to do a few more trades, but I'm going to pause it. I'm going to pause the recording because who's got time to watch me do this? All right. Okay. So I just finished up, right? And you can see the stats here. It was $79,000 in profit. Not bad. I mean, that's 2.5 years. It's obviously not the greatest, but we can take a look at some of the stats here by clicking the analyze button, and it'll show you some cool little stats. You can see my total was 333 pips. Let's go ahead and take a look. On average, a 0.1% a week, 0.5 a month. And so again, that's not terrible. The winning percentage was a total of 10 trades, 6 winners, 4 losers. And remember, if we're doing a 1-to-1, what is it? It's 52% is all you need to do. I really want you to focus on that. Don't worry about getting rich quick. Just focus on winning over 50%. This is 60%. I'll do this all day long. Any strategy I get that's over 50% and a 1-to-1, I'm really happy. It was an 8% ROI. It's great, okay? That's what we need to focus on. Okay, so again, you know, once you get that all set up and rolling, you know, you can tweak some of the strategies. You can do different things, improve it, trail your stop, test different money management stuff. This is how you become a profitable trader, by spending the time practicing. You got to do the work. You got to practice. That's the way to make it happen. All right, everybody. Thank you. And let me know in the comments if you have any questions or feedback. Really appreciate it. Thanks, and we'll see you on the next video. Bye.